Here we go. I'm looking.
Setting up your Facebook.
On your personal page, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'll look. Okay, I'm going on your personal. Okay.
Says directing to Facebook Live.
On your personal, right?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is. We're live.
On my personal?
On your personal.
Oh, on my personal page?
You're live on your personal page, so we have to copy and share.
Yeah, how come I don't see it?
I see.
There we go.
I see you right now.
Yes, I see it. Hold on. Now I'm going to share it.
We need to share it.
All right, hold on. Let me share it. Share it up.
Share it up. How are
you doing,
babe? What's going on?
I'm doing great. Here we are. Now I'm just going to share it. Hold on. We're getting it over to the Suki and Scott page, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, do that.
There we go. We'll kill a little time, so because we got time.
We're killing a little time? Okay, good.
All right, we're up.
All right, we're up and we're doing it. We just have to apologize to everybody because honestly, you think like this would be really easy, like Facebook and everybody would want everybody kind of talking at this moment as we're dealing with COVID and, but if that is not the case, ladies and gentlemen, that is not the case. That is not the case.
Ladies and germs, for some reason, Facebook will not let us bring the show up to the Suki and Scott page. So I had to put it on my personal page and shared it to the Suki and Scott page. I guess it's all the same thing. But, you know.
It's a mess. What am I going to do?
It's a mess.
So how are you? How was your day? Mess.
I'm good, babe. You know what?
I texted Wilkos. I think like me and him have different numbers because I texted him. And I didn't get a text back. And then I texted his wife, sent her a nice email. Hopefully they will respond. So we'll take it from there.
All right. Well, listen, the good news is.
What a day. Did you see the rain today? Was it raining by you?
It was raining. Now it's beautiful out. The wind was blowing. My hair was blowing. It was unbelievable. I actually made a trip, Suki. I made a trip to the supermarket today.
You did? How was that?
Masked up, gloves up. I mean, first of all, I tried to go to a Wegmans. The line was around the block for people waiting to get in. I said, no. I went to another one where nobody was there. It was beautiful. But, you know, you go down every aisle. There's not a paper good to be had. It's unbelievable. Still no paper goods to be had.
When do you think will be the time that we start getting something like in terms of paper goods?
Like on a normal supply? I don't know. People are still hoarding. The shelves are empty. They're absolutely empty. And it's just insane. And then everybody's in the supermarket. Everybody's got the masks on the gloves, right? There's one guy walking around. He's got a t-shirt and shorts on. No gloves, no mask. Like it's just another day in the supermarket. And I'm
can
like,
I tell you in this day and age when they're saying that you have to have your face covered, that this is sort of a public health issue, this is not just about you, but this is about everybody, the community, this is the community health. I think that's really ballsy. You gotta have big cojones to walk out there now with no gloves, no nothing. You know what I mean? It's crazy.
Yeah, no, this guy, it was just like he's talking to everybody, like it was just
don't talk to me. Don't look at me, don't talk to me,
sneeze. It's ridiculous. So what else did you do? Did you do like a big shop so you don't have to go out for another 2 weeks or
Suki,
how much chicken did you buy?
I bought chicken. I have enough chicken for 10 families right now. Oh, did we make a meal tonight, Paula, like nobody's business?
Paula is saying hello like she always does. She always says hello to us, Paula. And somebody else did. Was it Victor that said hello too? I don't know. I think they did too. So anyway, I'm
Frank Cipolla's watching. Remember Frank Cipolla?
Hi, Frank. Yes, I do. Absolutely.
Frank used to work with me at Channel 9. Great broadcaster. Yeah. I see my girl Naomi's watching.
How's Frank doing?
You never met Naomi, did you?
I never met Naomi, no.
Naomi used to, she used to be on with Scott and Todd in the morning. My good buddy, Naomi Salvatore. She was Naomi DiClemente.
Yes, Naomi DiClemente. Yes.
You know Naomi. Yes. I think you, didn't you have her on the Fox 5 show when PLJ was closing up?
I think I feel like I did. I don't know.
She may have been on with you guys because I had her on when I was on WABC radio filling in for Bernie and Sid. PLJ was closing down. I had Naomi on, but
okay.
Yeah.
Well, are you drinking today or not?
What's that?
Are you drinking today or not? I'm trying White Claw today.
You know what the problem is? I always come down and I have all these technical problems and I always forget to bring the alcohol.
Can I tell you? I mean, this is like real. I'm wondering if there's so many people doing so many things online right now that there's such an interface overload. The broad bandwidth. What is it? My husband was saying the bandwidth might not
be. Is that what it is, Suka? Bandwidth over. Let me ask you a question. How come Pornhub never gets a brand bandwidth overload ever? They never freeze up, never go down.
How come Pornhub never goes down?
They never go down.
Well, you know what he said? They've got probably got more than, they probably have a T1 line, a commercial server line, and they will never go down because we are all sitting, we don't have all these backups. And you know what it is? So many people that are bloggers, the Instagram kids, all that.
They're killing us, Suki. They're killing us.
No. They have a better gig of service. They had probably a T1 line drawn into their house. I thought we had T1
line. Listen, last night. Last night, we had a great show at Steve Wilkos, right?
Great show. Great show.
Everything was beautiful. So today I go to log on Zoom and put us up on Facebook Live. It won't let us do the Suki and Scott page Facebook Live. So now we're rolling on my personal page, flipped over to our page. So anybody who's watching on my personal page, pop on over to Suki and Scott Show. Because I got to tell you what, coming up in about 15 minutes, we have the very funny Vic DiBitetto. Suki, you know Vic. He rants about everything. And he first popped on the scene when with the, you know, I first know him from the, you know, every time we had a storm come and he had the video, gotta get the milk, gotta get the
eggs. Gotta get the milk. Can I tell you something? I just decided to share our link on my own personal page.
Go ahead.
It's not letting me.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. What's it telling you now?
Okay. I'm going to say share and I say post it. And it says something went wrong. We're working on getting it fixed as soon as possible.
I'm telling you, this is Facebook. They're trying to screw the white man again, Suki. It's Facebook. They got something going. Facebook. I'm surprised they don't have a problem with Zoom. You know, rebroadcasting everybody on Facebook. You know, they got to want to get a little money. Who's the guy behind you? There's a random guy in the shot. Who is it?
It was Eric. He was like, clear the page, try and load it up. I mean, he's trying to help us do like all this stuff. I'm like, what the heck is going on?
I made
meatballs tonight and he's very happy. In honor of Vic, I made meatballs.
You made a little meatballs.
I love when Vic comes on.
Do you ever see Vic's his Facebook posts?
Love
and
it.
I'm sure he's going to do it. I love when he comes on, he goes, all right, hello, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, your sister's ass. He's very funny. That'll be good. He'll be on in a sec. And let me tell you what we got coming on tomorrow night.
Okay.
Dave Clark.
Uh-huh.
I've been telling you about this guy. He's a Billy Joel impersonator.
Oh, I can't wait for that.
Not an impersonator. He's a Billy Joel tribute musician.
Right.
He's talented on his own, but he does Billy Joel songs like nobody's business. So, Suk, tomorrow night, you and I, we're going to sit back. I'm going to have a little tequila in my hand. Everybody, we're going to let this guy play. We'll talk to him, but we're going to let him play. And you and I are just going to sit back and sing and enjoy a Friday night with Billy Joel.
We're going to have a great time. I love it. That's a good way to have it. You know, I've been wanting to go. you know what? I've been wanting to go to see Billy Joel. I did it like the first time around, you know, going to see him at Madison Square Garden. And then I saw him a second time. But now I would like to go see him a third time this summer. And you know what's so crazy is that I don't even know if we're going to be able to go to concerts and things like that. That's way too many people together. Are not going to happen.
It's over. Ellen Matthews says this should become a real show. I'd watch it.
Us too, Ellen. We're hoping something happens.
Already lined up for next week. Ready for this?
Go.
And again, the names, because I write them down and I forget the names. But people, listen, this is becoming like the Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. People are reaching out to us to have people on the show.
Remember Carlos Austin? It's unbelievable. Remember Carlos Austin from WPIX days? He then went to NBC Universal. He goes like this. Oh my God. He goes, I saw you had Steve on and Jerry on. And I go like this, listen, Carlos, you got any guests from NBC that you want to hook up on the Suki and Scott show? We're open.
Yeah, we're open for business.
We are big.
So next week we have a young lady who was the a winner of The Voice. She's going to be coming on. An 18-year-old girl is going to be coming on to sing for us. We have another magician who's he's like an online magician. I was looking at this guy. Phenomenal, Souk. Unbelievable. He does things with bowling balls I've never seen before.
Has he seen your trick with your baseballs?
Which one? Which trick? I think my wife is vacuuming right above my head as we speak. No respect for the show whatsoever. I know Sharip is coming back on because we had technical problems with him. They've got that crazy podcast out now with the Sopranos. He and Michael Imperioli. So we've got a lot of things cooking already for next week. So listen, we'll take the weekend off. I know you're going to celebrate Easter on Sunday.
Yep.
And then, you know, Monday, we're right back at it. We got to keep everybody entertained at least for an hour every night, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It sounds like there's a hurricane over my head right now. Do you hear that?
You know what? I can't hear anything, so that's a good thing. So don't worry about it.
Good. Let's see. Barbara Irwin. Hi, Suki and Scott.
Hi, Barbara. How are you doing?
Everybody signing on, saying hello. We will have Vic DiBitetto should be coming on. I sent him the link. He should be on with us.
So you want to talk about COVID and the numbers out of curiosity? So you know how they're saying like in New York, like we've reached the, you know, we're kind of close to the peak or near the peak or somewhere near.
Yes.
But here's the problem. Here's the problem that I feel like our authorities are giving us a false sense of hope. Like all of this is going to restart and everything is going to go back to normal.
No, I know
in my heart, if we don't have a vaccine or we don't have the testing in place that actually says, you know, are you COVID positive? Like you and I can be COVID positive and be asymptomatic. And they're hoping that these people that are COVID positive that are asymptomatic can then enter the workforce slowly. Now, here's my thing. We don't all have testing for all of us New Yorkers right now on the table. So obviously this is going to be a slow rollout. This is not happening at the end of April. This is not maybe even going to happen till May or maybe June.
Keep going.
I think July, August. I mean, you think August, right? I actually think like life isn't really going to get to normal until then. I don't know. Call me crazy.
Listen, what, Ben? No, we're good. We were just talking about this today. Nobody knows when this thing is going to be safe to go back out.
Listen, we saw Florida right now. Remember, Florida was 4 weeks behind us when it comes to COVID and self-isolation. Their cases are, this is they started self-isolating. What was it last week. Now their cases are up 17,000 and they're, how many people have lost their life? 370. I mean, I just don't understand. Like, this is like a wave that's going to go through so many different, like every state in the country is like a different country. You have to kind of look at it that way, with different population, with different things that are happening.
Right. And listen, this isn't brain surgery. We were talking about this 2 weeks ago when we said they just needed to, everybody was piecemealing and half-assing it, as my dad used to say.
Yeah.
It should have just shut down the country and just did everyone at the same time. And now it's, you know, okay, well, you know, Louisiana's getting cases. And like you said, Florida, and you're going to see the middle of the country is going to start kicking in. Chicago's a mess now. And it's just going to keep going round in circles if they don't shut it all down. Everything. You just got to shut it.
I mean, I feel like, you know, you could say signs of the curve flattening. Okay. Coronavirus surge, you know, past, you know, for the third straight day, well past 5,000 in New York, more than the number of people that were killed on 9/11, which in itself was the most devastating day. But that doesn't mean the tragedy is going to end. It's not going to end, because we're still seeing people that are COVID positive, that are still in the ICU, that are still on ventilators, and we don't know what that's going to happen, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, no.
To date, more than 9,000 tri-state residents have lost their lives to COVID-19. And nearly 220,000 people that live in the tri-state have been infected.
And you know what the worst part is? When you hear some of these stories, you know, people are dying alone.
Oh, the worst.
Family members can't get, they can't even get to speak to them. You know, I heard stories the other day. Who was it? Oh, Gary Delabate on Howard Stern. On Howard Stern. I guess Gary's father-in-law passed away the other day. He was in the hospital. He was telling Howard how he and his wife, he was there for 2 weeks. If they spoke to him once, it was a lot. They would call. The nurse would maybe try to put the phone. Half the time they'd call, the people were too crazy at the desk, which you can understand, looking for, you know, an update on the guy. And he passed away in the hospital by himself. And they did. Now you go have to get the body and do a ceremony where people pull up in their cars to the graveside. It's absolutely awful.
You know, and there was a, you know, and that in itself is a huge tragedy. And we're going to be hearing stories of that time and time again. I was hearing how this story about these young kids who are now orphans because they're both, their mother and father passed away from COVID. I mean, can you imagine the horror of that crap? And let's talk about that. And also now the unemployment issue for people to get their money. You can't even get on the phone line. You can't even get on the phone line. And if you go into the website, you keep getting kicked out. You're like, what the hell?
Forget about the small
businesses. If you have a company with less than 500 people, you are screwed trying to get a home business loan right now.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's wild. I mean, 10 million people out of work right now. I mean, where's all that money coming from, by the way? Where does all that money come from?
You know where that comes from? Our taxes, because in the next 10 years, you're going to see how crazy our taxes. You know, the federal government isn't just giving you this, you know, money just to be like, hey, here you go. They're going to want it back. And how are they going to get it back? Property taxes. On your federal taxes. State taxes, local taxes, education taxes, whatever it is, you're going to get taxed up your ass.
It's going to be.
My husband said that was a lot. That was a lot. But you know what I'm saying? Can I tell you something?
Did you say taxed up the ass? Are you allowed to say that on here?
But you know what I'm saying? Like, listen, I currently don't have a job right now, right? You know, I've had my good days, and currently I'm part of the unemployment line. And it's just very, very, very scary to know that you can't even get through and you don't even know what to do. And can you imagine the PTSD, these healthcare workers and these guys on the front line, the grocery store clerks who earn nothing, right?
Our food chain is
you know?
Is problematic because what happens to all these people in like Amazon centers and the...
Eric was saying our food...
In the back?
No, he was saying an important point. He learned, he was reading an article. They said our food chain may also be in jeopardy because all of these frontline workers who are here right now,
yeah,
what's going to happen when they start falling sick? That the people that are making the deliveries, delivering the mail, you know, that those percentage points are going to go up slowly. You're seeing that in the NYPD already. You're going to start seeing this. And now you're also seeing this in hospitals where, you know, workers are getting sick. So there's a lot of challenges. And I understand that, you know, it's going to be really tough, but boy, so many people are in limbo mentally. You can't mourn the death of somebody that you love. Limbo when it comes financially, because you're waiting for the federal government to take charge.
Mm-hmm.
And then limbo just physically, because you can't do the things that you, this is like a trifecta of sorts that we've never experienced in our lives. Right. And our children are experiencing this in some weird way too. What's going on?
Look who's here.
Oh, what's going on? Look who's here.
Vic, can you hear us, buddy? Uh-oh. I don't think we can hear him. Vic, can you hear me?
Tell him he's got to go to the bottom of the screen. Wait, connecting to audio. He's got to go to the bottom
goes.
Of the screen.
There he goes.
There you go.
Connecting. Come on, Vic. You could do it, baby.
Connecting to audio.
Connecting. It won't connect in. I'm not happy with Zoom, Sue.
All right,
there he is.
Let me tell you something. You know what ticks me off? You got to work for NASA to figure this out.
I do it
6:30
every night. Vic, every night I've been trying to get on this friggin' thing, man. We get it done, but you know, how just, you doing, bud?
Let me just tell Russell, because he's cursing me out. Let me tell him I'm in. Hold on.
Russell, I'm in.
I just got an email from Vic's agent and said, hey, I'm on a conference call in LA. Can you help Vic out? He can't get on. I said, I don't have his email.
You know what it is? Both my kids, they're not here anymore. Without my kids, I'm like, I am clueless with this stuff. I still have A-Track in my car.
What are you doing?
I got to tell you, Vic, Scotty and I have been having problem after problem every night trying to get it up. And it's just.
Hey now, not me, you.
I'm going to let that one go.
Yeah, Vic, that one went right by you.
Yeah,
pal.
Just for the guys.
Listen. I know you two are sensitive, so I wanted to let that one go.
All right.
But, you know, it's been very different. Vic, how you been? How's everything going?
You know what? Considering that the world just stopped, I really can't complain. You know, there are other comics who are worse shaped than me. Thank God I married a woman who knows how to handle finances. I don't even know how to post data check. But all my shows have been canceled. There's no income coming in, but I'm a hustler. I'm Italian. I got some things lined up here and there. I'm okay. Right now, I'm okay.
Vic, were you able to share this broadcast on your Facebook page? Any idea how to do that?
Please. You want me to have a seizure?
He goes, you want me to have a seizure?
How do I do that?
What's that?
Don't worry about it.
Listen, I was telling Suki how you usually start off all your rants when you go, hey, Instagram, Facebook, you know, Twitter, your sister's ass. Give me a quick open to the show.
Oh, you could curse on this?
Yeah.
Of course.
Oh, hey, what do you hear? What do you say? My Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, Google Plus, your sister's ass. Vic DiBitetto. Oh, the Pony Express. Can't forget the Pony Express. Vic DiBitetto here in my house in New Jersey, going insane with technology.
I completely feel you on that. I was trying to do something today. I was like, what the hell am I doing?
Can I post this later when it's done on my page?
Sure.
Yes.
Do me a favor. Just send Russell all the directions. I can't. Please.
Vic, I see your rants when you come on. I love the one you did where you're outside your neighbor's house and they were talking to you from the driveway. You know, what's got you all beefed up today, bud? What's got you ticked off? It's got to be something.
the quarantine, if me and my wife don't kill each other in the next day, it'll be a miracle. I'm running out of things to do. I counted rice in a package of rice. I pack in every piece of rice. I went to my attic. I put my albums in alphabetical order. I counted, I counted my pubes the other night. That's how bad it's getting.
You pew.
What was that?
By the way, I like that Emmy. Was that an Emmy behind you?
You know, it's funny you ask. A lot of people ask. There's not one, there's two.
Nice.
And there's five more upstairs. Suki has the same seven in her house.
Oh, yeah. Well, I got this from Home Goods. This is like a phony microphone from Home Goods.
We got between the two of us, Vic, we've got 14. We've got 14.
14, nice. Vic. It's no big deal.
So where are you guys right now? You're both in California?
No, we're both in. I'm in Westchester. He's in Jersey.
Oh, where in Jersey?
What do you think? I'm going to tell you over the phone here? I'm in Bergen County.
Oh, you guys are getting hit hard up there with the virus. Yeah, we're in...
Thank God, Vic. I'm still good.
I'm in Monmouth County. I'm in Manalapan, which is the gateway to Israel. I don't know if it's a pandemic or a Jewish holiday. There's no traffic out there.
Oh, it's you got your second night of Passover, my friend. Listen, we talked to Steve Wilkos last night, and you mentioned that you and your wife are about to kill each other I guess you're on this side of the spectrum, because there are other people on this side of the spectrum who are having sex like crazy.
A lot of sex.
Quarantine. Well, I'm going to put you on this side.
I can't complain in that department either. I mean, we're married 36 years. Last night we did some role playing.
Wow. Okay? Go ahead.
I dressed like a gladiator.
Right.
And of all the outfits to pick, she comes out dressed like a nurse. I'm like, are you kidding me? A nurse? Look, I might take my hat off to nurses, but can we do something different besides a nurse?
What would you have liked to see? What would you have liked to see?
A French maid. A cheerleader.
A cheerleader. He wants to role play. Okay.
You know what I do, Vic? I make my wife dress up like one of the briefcase girls from Deal or No Deal.
I like that.
That's a good one. Yeah, all 24 of them.
I'll be happy with any of those girls on The Price is Right.
And the two of you are like, you know, Scotty's like, you want to see my box? And then you're like, you want to see what's behind curtain number three?
Well, behind curtain number three in my house are plantation shutters. My house looks like Home Goods collided with the Pottery Barn.
That sounds beautiful.
And all my stuff winds up in the office down here. This is my stuff. It winds up. This is my man cave. This is where my shit winds up.
What exactly is that? An ampersand? What is that?
Yeah, an ampersand. Yeah, I never knew you called it that till you told me.
An ampersand or an and sign?
It's an and sign, yeah.
It's the and symbol.
Yeah. That's great. Hey, Vic, did you really shoot through the roof? I feel like you came to the forefront of a lot of people when you came out with the got to get the milk and eggs routine. Back
bread
and out of your driveway. Bread and the milk.
The milk and the bread.
No, bread and milk. It's got a better ring to it.
All right, bread and milk.
Let me explain something. I've been doing videos since 2009, but the bread and milk was the only one that went viral. People think that's the one that made me. I mean, I have over 8,000 videos since I started. If you put all my videos together, me and my manager, we couldn't even calculate it. We're talking about hundreds and millions of views. Bread and milk alone is 20 million views.
Wow.
You put them all together, I mean, it's insane. There's no comic out there. Here I am, this 59-year-old chooch using the social media, and I have millions. That's why I'm selling out theaters and clubs all over the country. Because I'm tired of waiting for the break, so I did it myself. I did it my way, you know?
That's the way you got to do it, Mr. Sinatra. That's the way you need to do it.
I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few.
Listen, I want to know, you did a toilet paper PSA.
Right.
And I feel like everybody needs that PSA right now, Vic. I mean, I feel like we need to talk about this toilet paper issue in America.
I don't understand how this pandemic, all of a sudden, everybody's got to take a shit. If everybody If everybody would just shop, if everybody would just shop normally the way we've been shopping, there wouldn't be empty shelves. These hoarders are insane, you know? And then you get these animals, they get the old mask and the gloves and they throw them on the street. I mean, come on. You know, you think of pandemic, humans are a virus.
You know what, you know what Scotty and I are saying? The Gavones who are taking the gloves off. It's like the condom back in 1990 when you'd find it in the schoolyard. Oh, now you look at the glove, like the, not the love glove, the glove, the pandemic glove, this nasty, disgusting thing where you're like, don't touch it.
Well, back in Brooklyn, we used to call them the Coney Island whitefish.
Oh, yeah. What the hell is that?
A condom in the ocean.
Oh, God.
Exactly. Oh yeah.
Not a gefilte fish, a white fish.
No, that's in Brighton Beach.
The gefilte fish is in Brighton Beach.
Yeah. Vic, I went to the supermarket today, and when you go to get your cart, there's literally like sanitized wipes used hanging off the cart. You're like,
people are animals. We had to wait in line. See, over here where I shop is called Wegmans.
Wegmans, yeah.
Yeah, we had to wait in line.
That's a very upscale place.
It is. We had to wait in line 45 minutes, got it to keep 6 feet. And I told my wife, I felt like we were at the Universal Studios waiting to go into the mummy ride. That's what it felt like. They should have a sign, 22 minutes from here. But then once we got in, it was nice. It wasn't too crowded. And you got to go early. You got to go at least once a week. You know, that's the only time we leave the house to go shopping.
There's nowhere else to go, right?
And you know, Italians, we got to stock the pantry with food for 10 years.
It's like the final meal. Did you get all? So a lot of people are going through their Locatelli cheese withdrawal. Like they didn't buy enough Locatelli cheese to get them through. Look, show them our Locatelli.
Everybody, who's got Locatelli cheese? I don't have any Locatelli cheese.
This is all I have left in my Locatelli. That is not good. I gotta go and get more Locatelli.
That looks like crack cocaine. I prefer Parmigiano Ray Romano.
Ray Romano.
Vic, you are you missing sports? You gotta be missing sports right now. No, you're a big sports guy.
You know what? Believe it or not, sports is the last thing on my mind. I just want to go back on stage. I just want life to get back to normal. The only good thing about this, I'm a big Yankee fan. Maybe by time sports starts again, Giancarlo Stanton will be fully healed, that China doll that he is.
Yeah, he's very delicate, Stan, very delicate, for $30 million a year.
Please. And you know what? When this is all over, I think medical workers, they don't deserve the millions, not these athletes and these politicians and these movie stars. I think come on, man, they're on the front line, these poor people. They don't know if they're going to go home with the virus. Not just them, first responders. I used to drive a truck. Truck drivers, grocery store workers, anybody that's on the front line. You know, I'm kind of feeling bad that comedians went out essential, you know? But hopefully when this is over.
Neither are we.
You know what? I think what you said is completely honest and true. Like, I think like we've got it all messed up, right? We think we sit there and we pay our athletes and our, you know, actresses millions and millions of dollars. And then you got this guy, every day he's showing up at the A&P or the Stop and Shop. And I'm not talking about the manager of the store. Right. I'm talking about the guy that's in the back unloading the truck, earning a minimum wage every day, exposed to this, doesn't know if he's going to get sick. He might not even have health care, right? And you know, these guys are every day working for nothing and putting their life on the line. And you're talking about the nurses and the doctors, and you're talking about, how about the people that clean the hospital, the people that are mopping things up, who are sterilizing the bathrooms, who are cleaning all the crap, who are, you know, putting away the garbage. There are so many people that we need to thank every day for doing what they're doing. Actually, I saw this one piece which made me really sad, and I don't mean to make it sad, Scotty, because I know you want to laugh, but this one doctor, she got so sick that they had to intubate her, and she made a goodbye video to her kids because she was so bad that they didn't think that she was going to make it out. survival rate when you're intubated is like 20%. 20% of the people that are intubated actually come out. Do you know that?
No, I never knew that. Remember the Bronx Tale? The working man is the tough guy.
Now you just can't leave.
Without the gun, let him go to work each day. That's the tough guy. You know, I broke my ass, but since 1978, I worked two jobs. I drove a garbage truck, a dump truck, a school bus. You know, I've been there. I know what it's like. It's just, hopefully.
And now you're living down by the ocean. Look at you. You're in a mansion.
I'm actually, even though they say there's no Central Jersey, I'm in Central Jersey. I'm between Springsteen and Bon Jovi. That's right.
Let me ask you, you were talking, you did a bit about getting old. Like, you know, what are your feelings about getting old in America?
I had a very depressing moment last month. I never thought this day would come. My family jewels actually touched the toilet water.
No.
And here's the best part. I was taking a piss. Think about that.
That's low-hanging fruit, Vic.
I'm praying to God, please, God, I hope the toilet's backing up. It wasn't. They were going down to the water. And my wife uses that blue Tidy Bowl stuff. I thought I was dunk. I was making Easter eggs, you know? I was going.
Okay, wait, I'm confused. So this was late at night. You didn't want to stand to take a number one. You wanted to sit on the bowl and, like, do that.
No, I was.
No, he was standing, Sue.
I was standing. That's how low they hung. See, they middle of night. I can't go to the bathroom in the middle of the night because then I wake the cat up and the cats are jumping on our heads and my wife says, don't get up to pee. So what do you want me to do, pee in the bed? I got to pee. What am I going to do? My prostate is getting big. I'm 59. You know, you got to go. And the cat, you wake up in the morning, the cat's ass is in your face. I tell my wife, why can't you put your ass in my face? You're sick. Is that all you think about?
It's okay for the cat though, right? Sook, Vic, I got you on this. Sook, when you get to Vic's age, the testicles start to hang a little lower than normal. Not like a young boy where they're tight to the body.
Well, unless you take a warm shower. And then it brings it all back up again.
Somebody wants me to ask you about Home Goods. They said, ask Vic about Home Goods.
That's for my wife. Well, thank God. That's one good thing about the pandemic. We can't go to Home Goods. That's where we go, Home Goods. That's a big store of miscellaneous shit that doesn't match or make any sense. It's shit you're going to see at a... You see this? This you're going to see at a yard sale next spring.
How much you love.
And you women, you shop at that place like
shops. I love Home Goods.
That's my job. I got to guard the product she wants to buy while she goes browsing. You stand right over there. I like that chair. I saw this chair first. I'll be over there. Watch this chair. Now I'm guarding the chair like one of these Buckingham Palace soldiers. If I don't come home with the chair, forget it. I don't have flex for a month. That's now I have Home Sense, which is like Home Goods on steroids.
Which one?
Home Sense.
I've never been there. Yeah, I've never been to Home Sense.
Forget it. When we go by Home Sense, my wife, her nipples come out. Oh, can we go browsing? Yeah, I'm break out in a rash because I know what I'll be doing in the next half hour.
Picking up, when my wife talks about Home Goods, she says, if you hit it on a good day, you could find just about anything you need. Yeah, you got to hit it on a good day.
Yeah, okay. The Hindenburg was a good airline. Look, I'm all set for Easter. I got the chocolate Easter bunny. I got the Easter cocky. See? The cocky that comes out of the Easter bunnies. That's enough. I don't want another peep out of you.
Oh, peeps. Those are the best.
Yeah, you put them in a microwave. You ever do that?
No.
No.
Try it. You'll see what I mean.
They blow up. They blow up nice.
Yeah. 30 seconds. Perfect.
That's like, Vic, do you like Malamars?
No, I'm not a big marshmallow guy.
Oh, you put, what? Peeps are marshmallows.
I know. I don't eat them. I just use them as props.
Oh, yeah. You put a Malamar in the microwave for 13 seconds. You got a beautiful s'more. It's beautiful. You'd love it.
I'll tell I like wife, s'mores.
She loves marshmallows.
What? You got any good movies, shows you're watching while you're quarantined?
We binge watched everything on Hulu, Roku, Cuckoo Cachoo. We're running out of things to watch. It's getting bad, man. If this thing goes another few weeks, I don't know what I'm going to do. I might go in the attic and get my GAF viewfinder.
Oh, you remember the viewfinder?
Remember the GAF?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had one of those with a Brady Bunch wheel.
Right. You put the wheel in, you click the thing.
And if
for
you
the younger look, people, Google GAF.
Yeah. If you keep both eyes open, it was 3D, right?
Yes.
Nothing better than the.
How old are you? You're not my age.
Me?
How old are you?
Let's just say my testicles aren't as low as yours right now. All right. But they're not that low yet.
What are you, 49?
Yeah. Perfect. Okay.
Who's that kid behind you? Who is that?
That's me. That's
really?
That's me. That's me from when I was.
Is that
I was 10.
Is that a fish tank behind you? Is that, yeah.
What's
yeah,
that?
Yeah, the fish tank, yeah. Those are, you got African cichlids. Those are blood parrots. They're great fish. I have them like 3 years now. You can't really see them from here. I like animals.
African, what's an African cichlid?
Cichlids. It's a type of fish. I don't know. They call them cichlids. I don't know. Maybe I'm saying it wrong.
Can I tell you something? My son won a fish. No joke. He's right over there. Won a fish at one of those fairs. He was 2 years old. He's now 10. My husband has resuscitated this goldfish, no joke, by feeding him dry peas when he has gastrointestinal blockage. And then he like puts that along, you know what? And then he swims like and he's happy again. So
you mean he gave him mouth to mouth?
No, he had a little blockage in the tummy.
Rubber glove, Sook?
No, rubber. Yeah, he's done that. Rubber glove, he feeds the thing, he shoves the pea in his mouth, he eats it, and then he goes poo, and he's perfectly fine again.
Good for him, Dr. Wellfish. You laugh like Lou Costello.
Right?
Or Muttley. Remember Muttley?
Muttley.
From the Rocky Races?
Yeah.
Rocker,
from the races. Oh my
God. Do you know when we were actually on TV, people would take my voice when I was laughing and then put it with Muttley and then back to me, cut it back. Yeah.
There you go. Vic, see, I'm very observant.
Observant there, Vic. You're good.
No one's ever said Lou Costello, though. That was a good one. That, he really
I've never
does.
Heard Lou, I've never heard Lou Costello laugh.
Yeah. Oh, he was great.
He didn't laugh. It was when he got nervous.
When he got nervous.
When Abbott and Costello met Frankenstein.
Yes.
When he was in the wooden thing. Frank Jr. Chick.
Yeah. That's when Dracula would come out and he'd lay back down every time Lou would show up.
We come from a different time. We will never, ever see. You know what I do when I want? Yes, before what I watch. I go to YouTube. And I put in Don Rickles, Frank Sinatra on The Tonight Show.
How about the roast?
You're not going to see entertainment like that anymore. Those days are gone.
Do you ever go on and watch the roast with Dean Martin and Rickles and those guys?
Classic.
It's unbelievable.
That's when we laughed at each other, with each other. It wasn't politically correct. It was a different time, man. George Carlin was my idol. I love George Carlin. If he was around today, forget about it.
Can
you
I ask
you Coach Colin on Facebook? I got offended by those 7 dirty words. I can't believe you said that. Block me, unfriend me. Holy shit.
What do you think about like Kimmel and what do you think about all the people that are going live at at their house right now? Is it really funny? Is it really working for you? What do you think? Should they just do reruns and call it a day?
Well, as a matter of fact, me and my manager, we're working on something in a few weeks. Hopefully, that might be the new norm to do it from home. I think it's a great idea. Because even when and if this pandemic ever ends, I'm worried who the hell is going to go to a 1,600-seat theater and sit with all these people? Maybe they'll sell it at half capacity. I don't know. But in the meantime, you got to reinvent yourself. And that's... how cool is this that we could do? This is like the Jetsons. It's amazing.
It's amazing, right?
You know, from everything that bad happens, something good comes out of it. So who knows?
No, absolutely. But now you need to have broadband in your house. You need to have, what is it, honey? 1K, 1 gig. Oh, you got to get, you got to get.
I'll be happy with 1 gig at this point.
Vic, do you remember When your parents took you to Disney when you were younger, or you went to Disney back in the day?
No.
When you'd go, oh, you never went?
The furthest I ever went was Lake George.
I love Lake George. Do you remember that? You remember Spaceship Earth at Epcot?
Yes.
Yes.
When you would ride through Spaceship Earth, and you would see all of these things on the exhibits that are going to be in the future. And now here it is. We're doing all those things that were in Spaceship Earth.
Yep.
It's unbelievable.
I mean, the Jetsons was so ahead of its time. It really was, when you think about it. I mean, to do comedy now with Zoom, now you could get an audience of like 100 people and do stand, but it's nothing like a live audience right there. But I don't know. What's all that noise?
Yeah, all that clanking? I hear a lot of clanking.
What's that, the Tin Man?
What's going on here?
Eric, turn around.
Oh, that's a nice kitchen. Very nice.
I mean, what's Stephen Colbert doesn't have this at night when he's doing his monologue.
He's being robbed? Who is that guy? Pay no mind for that man behind the counter.
Because Saturday night, and Sook, I think you'll be a part of this. You just don't know it yet. Okay. There's a show on called Laughter Saves Lives.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a show from 6 to 10 on Facebook and YouTube. They have Piscopo and a whole bunch of different comedians.
Yep.
I think that I'm going to do like 5 minutes of stuff.
Great
and
idea.
It's basically to raise money for the healthcare workers.
Great idea.
And it's coming up Saturday night, and it's going to be great. It's, you know, and basically, but the thing is, you're doing comedy, Vic, and you don't get that immediate response of the laughter, which has got to be tough.
You know, I think eventually everything's going to get back to normal. I don't know when. But I think people are going to have cabin fever. They're going to want to go out. They're going to want to go out to eat. They're going to want to go out to a Broadway play, to a comedy show. It won't be the same, but it's got to have some kind of normalcy again, you know?
I hope it's soon.
I don't know. This is foreign territory to us.
I think normalcy will come as testing comes. We got to get the testing in place to find out who is... And then I don't know how long that's going to take, because there's how many New Yorkers are there in New York State?
They got more than any country in the world, they just said today. I don't know if that was testing or deaths. I don't know.
No. We got to get the testing in place for the people that are living in order to have people reemerge and go back into the workforce and start, you know, who has been exposed to COVID and who has tested positive and who. And then there's another test that we have to do to find out who has antibodies. And could those antibodies then be used to find a cure, which is ultimately what we need to do, a cure, a vaccine.
Yeah.
Or treatment.
Vic, are you one of those guys that you remember the first joke you ever wrote?
Oh, boy. I went on stage at Pip's Comedy Club in Brooklyn. 1981, I went up with a bunch of props, and I would whip out like a roll-on deodorant, and I would say, look, Mick Jagger's chapstick, stuff like that. And when I was a garbage man, I found these two mannequin heads. Remember Gimbals? Gimbals.
I love Gimbals.
Yeah. Gimbals was A+.
Yeah, and I had a female mannequin and a male mannequin, and I would put on Herb Alpert music in the background, and they would kiss, and eventually she would go down on him, and he would go. It was the ultimate blowjob joke, but all you saw were just two heads. It was fucking genius. But you knew what was going on, but that's all you saw were two heads. So how do you get offended?
Which Herb Alpert song did you put on? I'm curious.
It was called May, M-A-E. Went like this. Herb Alpert.
You have that album?
Yeah, up in the attic in alphabetical order.
So wow. what's the A? What's the first album?
Going Places.
No, what's the first album in your alphabetical order?
Oh man. You got me on that one.
Is it by band or by, it's gotta be by band, by artist,
by band,
right?
Oh, ABBA.
Oh, nice.
I was big with the Saturday Night Fever. That was my neighborhood, Bensonhurst. That's what we did. We went dance. That's why I met my wife in 1978 at a disco, you know? That was it.
You went to Space Odyssey?
Space Odyssey, Infinities, Pastels, the Night Gallery.
Pastels.
Yeah. Night Gallery. Those were the days, man. I just missed getting killed by Son of Sam by one night.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Fucked up. Those are the 70s, man. That was the time. The Yankees, back-to-back World Series. Rocky came
Bronx
out.
Is burning, Rocky baby.
Came out.
And Bronx was burning. You're right.
It was a great time. It's a great time.
I'm going to take you back. How'd you dance, Vic? Show me. Let me see.
I had my moves back in the day. Oh, yeah.
Isn't it funny how everybody's just wearing sweat? Nobody gets out of sweats now anymore. Isn't that great? Nobody gets out of the sweat.
Especially now. Especially now. I can't remember the last time I got dressed up.
How many pairs of sweatpants do you own? How many pairs of stretchy pants do you own at this point?
Well, I got the whole outfit. I got the velour jumpsuit, like the wise guys, you know? Hey, yeah, sure, you got a guy.
I got a guy.
I got the Brooklyn brand. I got them all.
All right, Vic, best mob movie ever made.
Oh, easy.
It has to, see, The Godfather stands
take
alone.
Take the Godfather out.
One and two, to me, was one movie, one and two. Part three, I don't even want to talk about part three. But then you got Goodfellas.
Perfect.
But everybody forgets, even though it wasn't a mob movie per se.
I like The Bronx Tale.
Raging Bull was a masterpiece.
Oh, Raging Bull. Well, listen, now you're just talking De Niro movies now.
Masterpiece.
Bronx Tale was good too.
Bronx Tale, Donnie Brasco.
Donnie Brasco.
Casino was Goodfellas Goes to Vegas.
Right.
And of course, Scarface.
Oh, that's my favorite.
Yeah, Scarface. Yeah. Scarface.
Love
Cologino. Cologino, don't you ever forget.
I can watch those movies over and over. My wife gets, don't you get tired of these movies? I'm like, don't you get tired of The Big Bang Theory? I don't get that show. I stare
we're
at
gonna,
that
I just we're stare at that show on.
Like this.
Big Bang?
I don't know. Maybe it's me. I don't know.
Do you like Ozark?
I haven't checked it out yet.
Vic, best show on TV, Ozark. Go check that out. You'll love it.
What's with this tiger thing?
Who knows? I can't get into it.
It's a documentary that took like 8 years to make. It's got sex. It's got all of the elements that make it crazy. It's got crazy. It's a documentary, so it's real. It's real.
Okay. I'll check out Ozark. I hear a lot of people's good things about that one.
Listen, you start from season one. You get every episode is phenomenal. You're going to love it.
How many episodes?
It's three seasons, like 10 episodes each. But you're gonna be you get when it ends. It's one of those shows when it ends, you're depressed that you don't have another episode.
Like Ray Donovan, that was my favorite show.
Ray Donovan
went by like that. I'm like, I can't believe it's over. Yeah. Now is it coming back?
Brilliant. No. Well, apparently no. they canceled it, but then I think Liev Schreiber tweeted something out that because of the backlash, it might be coming back.
I hope so.
Wow.
Yeah.
I like it better when he's in Boston. I like the Boston when he was in Boston.
You mean L.A.?
L.A.
You liked it when he was in L.A.?
Right. That's what I meant.
Yeah. Oh, it's such a great show, man. Really is. And how about Homeland? You ever watch that one?
No, that's another one. I know. Yeah.
Listen. Get off the Pornhub for 5 minutes and put on Homeland or Ozark. What are you doing?
I'll give it a shot tonight, I promise. Normally I go to bed right after Jeopardy. I go to bed. If I don't have a show, I go to bed right after Jeopardy.
What do you get up at, 4?
Believe it or not, yeah, 4. I toss and turn now. I don't sleep late. I'm like an old man. I go to bed early. I wake up early.
Let me ask you a question. Your days in sanitation. The whole time you were on sanitation, were you thinking about like things that you would see that would inspire you, that would inspire your early comedy, and like kind of create this person that you're going to be?
Well, I used to do a couple of jokes about the homeless people. You know, let me explain before people get upset. See, when back in my day, they were called bums. Now they're homeless. I mean, to me,
hobos and bums.
Right. To me, a homeless person is somebody who loses their house. You know, there's a hurricane, a tornado, the house is gone. That's a homeless person. I mean, most of these people, they're crazy, man. And you know, you go in the subway, they slash your face now. And one time I was picking up a box, a guy jumped out and said, "That's my house. That's my house." I'm like, "Take it. You can have it." I didn't know there was a guy in that. He was sleeping in the dumpster. We had him hooked up with the chains about to, and he, I'm like, "Dude, what are you, scared the shit out of me." I bought him some coffee. I bought him a sandwich. But, you know, being a garbage man, you see New York at a different, had the graveyard shift. 12 midnight I started on 34th Street, Midtown Manhattan.
Wow.
You know, one morning I saw a rat give birth. I saw it all. I saw a rat give birth as I'm eating a bacon and egg and roll with a cup of coffee. Didn't even faze me.
And you know what? And you were like in sanitation when the city was filthy. Everybody was disgusting. Animals littering.
Yep.
People would roll down the windows and just throw their stuff out the window.
And I never got a virus. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. Who the hell knows where this thing came
Vic,
from?
If you were on a game show, like a Star Search. Remember Star Search with Ed McMahon?
Yeah.
If you were on a Star Search and you had to do 1 minute of comedy to move on to the next level, is there a routine in your head that you would go to for that right 1 minute that would guarantee you to get through to the next level?
Yeah, I would talk about my son, who was an artist, and he graduated FIT in New York City, full scholarship, made the honors 4 years in a row. I sent him to Stop and Shop one night to get lettuce. He comes back with cabbage. You know what he tells me? Oh man, what's the difference? What's the difference? You're an idiot, that's the difference. Moron, street smarts, idiot, common sense. He was an artist. One winter, instead of helping me shovel the snow, he painted a picture of me shoveling the snow.
Yeah, but listen, you'll have that forever.
Yeah, well, they're in Scotland now. Both my kids moved to Scotland. How do you think I feel in this pandemic? I can't even see my kids.
Wow, they're in Scotland. Why did they end up in Scotland?
They went there on vacation. They fell in love. And we love the culture. I'm like, "You're Italian, you fucking idiot. What do you mean you love the culture? You're Italian." But they're happy. They both met somebody. My son, he came out of the closet 5 years ago. He's happy. Good. He met some guy. Now they're both wearing dresses. Hey, good for them. They're happy. Good for them. Kilts. A kilt, I meant. I didn't
kilts.
Even. Hey, I got nothing. Hey, I always tell people who think you just suspect their kid is gay, would you rather him come out of the closet or hang himself in a closet? You got to get
absolutely.
Life is too short. I love my son. I hugged him. I kissed him. I started tearing up. I said, "Daddy, why are you tearing up?" I said, "Well, next time mommy goes to Home Goods, you're going to fucking take her." I know you people love that shit. And he started crying. "What are you crying for? I can't wait. When is she going?" Is there a theme? He's a good kid. He's a good kid. They're good. They're well-mannered. He's happy. That's all that matters.
Well, Scotland,
listen, you
could
zoom him up.
Beautiful.
Zoom him up. You get him on the line.
I've been there 3 times. It's a beautiful country. It really is.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful. The food. The haggis, right? You got to eat the haggis.
You couldn't pay me to eat that shit.
How about the scotch? You like the scotch?
I'm not a big scotch. I swear to God, I thought you were going to get robbed for a second. You scared the shit out of me. He's got an FDNY shirt.
There, right?
So do I. Look.
Oh, look. He's FDNY. Oh.
Nice.
Nice.
I always support firemen, law enforcement, EMS, first responders. I always support them.
that
my husband's an FDNY. He's a chief in the FDNY.
Nice.
Vic, where can our audience find you online? Where can they see you?
VicDiBitetto.net. It's all there. I got a YouTube channel. I got videos. I post my videos every day. I got an album called Working Class Zero. I got merch. I got everything. Just go there. Take the time out. Have patience. Don't be impatient like me trying to get this freaking Zoom meeting. Just VicDiBitetto.net. Worst comes to worst, go to Google, put in Vic D, everything comes up.
Love you, Vic. Awesome.
Did you happen to catch Suki's husband Swiffering behind her just now?
Yeah, he's Swiffer.
Yeah. Nothing like seeing a big guy with a fireman shirt with a Swiffer.
Talk about it.
Please don't tell me he walks a French poodle. Hey, how you doing? Actually, they say when men clean around the house, women think that's very sexy.
I do. I was going to say, Vic,
you talk about role playing. When Suki gets off here, he's in for a little treat, this guy.
Yeah.
I'm gonna scrub every piece of flooring in my house now. Please, wish me luck.
Listen, Vic, I cooked all day, and then he finishes up. You know, that's how we do it. We trade off.
Listen, when this is all over, I'm serious. You got to stay in touch with Russell. Come to one of my shows.
I would love to.
We'll get you
absolutely
some comps.
We love you.
Come to the green room, but you got to stay 6 feet apart.
We don't even have to pay. We don't have to pay to come to the show.
You know me. You got a guy.
I gotcha.
Vic, when you work in sanitation, do you ever think you'd be telling people, yeah, talk to Russell, we'll get you some comps. He's my guy.
I never thought in a million years. You know what? The American dream is still alive. I know it's crazy right now. People are losing jobs and there's unemployment is through the roof. But I was a garbage man. I drove a dump truck, a cement truck, and a school bus for 13 years. And now the fruits of my labor is finally paid off. I'm still fighting the fight. But I never in a million years thought I'd be in a position. This is surreal to me right now. This is amazing. And I thank you for it.
Oh, we love you.
Yeah, just being on this show tonight has got to be surreal for you, right?
Absolutely. I mean, who else is doing this? You know? Firemen?
Vic DiBitetto, ladies and gentlemen. Vic, you're the best, buddy. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Let's do this again, all right?
Vic,
absolutely.
My husband just wants to say hello.
Hey, Vic, hello.
How are you? I represent, baby.
Nice.
Vic, listen, we'll have you on again. We'll have you on again in August when we're all still stuck in our homes.
Yes, bro. Tribeca. Tribeca.
Tribeca.
I got a guy
for you.
Hey.
Yeah, all right.
Nice.
Look at this. I'll show you. Hold on. Don't go nowhere.
Oh, look at those guns.
We got nowhere to go.
Suk, where's he going? What's he doing?
I don't know. He said he's going to go.
I was the Grand Marshal a few years ago for the Columbia Association in the
Columbus Day Parade.
You can't see Bratton. Bratton is back there.
I love Bratton.
You look like a much younger man.
We were walking together. It's me, Bratton, and my wife, and we passed the CVS, and I go to Bratton. Are your feet killing me? You want me to go into CVS and get the Dr. Scholl's gelling? He started cracking up. I was the Grand Marshal for the Little Italy.
I love it.
You look like a much younger man.
San Gennaro, yeah, oh yeah.
San Gennaro feast, yeah.
It was great. I was jumping off the float, shaking hands. They said no Grand Marshal ever jumped off the float.
Vic, in that picture, you look.
I gotta go like, now. I gotta clean up.
Yeah, you look like a much younger guy whose testicles aren't touching the water yet, bud.
No, actually, that was before my hair plugs. Really, these are hair plugs.
Really? Those really? Look good.
They took the hair from my ass and they put it on my head. My wife always says I was a shit head.
Listen, your hair's a little curly.
Oh, you're good, you. All right, I gotta go. Thank you for having me.
Vic, we love you, pal.
Thank you.
You'll put this on your page when we throw it up.
Tell Russell how to do this. I'm clueless. I don't know how to shut this fucking thing off. what do I do? I'm just leaving this on all night.
Let's watch him, Sook.
Let's watch the fish for me.
Walk out the room. Walk out the room.
Take care.
Bye.
Yeah, Vic, I'm leaving. Vic, I'm leaving you up till you shut it off.
Oh, here we go. I think I got it. Bye. No.
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 Just X out.
Leave meeting.
Vic.
Leave
I
meeting.
I can get rid of you, but I won't.
All right.
See you later, bud.
Bye.
Ah, he got it.
That was great.
Ah.
That's funny.
Another
he actually went, let me tell you something. When he saw Eric coming at me, he was like this. He was like, "Who the
hell
is that?"
It's very, it's back there. And then you see him wet swiffing, like, you know.
He's wet swiffing.
He's wet swiffing back there. Listen, don't forget tomorrow night.
Yes.
We've got a Billy Joel night tomorrow night.
Good.
This guy's playing the piano. He's going to blow us away.
I love it.
We get
all
to
right.
sit back.
Sounds good.
And then over the weekend, we'll get more guests. We got plenty more coming.
All right. Love you. Talk to you later. That was great.
All right, babe.
All right.
We'll talk to you. What's today? Thursday? Tomorrow's Friday.
Thursday,
we got one more night.
Tomorrow's Friday. Tomorrow's Friday.
All right, babe. That was good. He was funny, right?
Really good. Really good. Vic DiBitetto. We gotta support him when we all get back to normal.
Yeah.
Go see his shows and definitely keep in touch, you know? Support.
Everybody, the one thing you always see on here, Suki swinging from the lights later. Suki, you got a good one, I guess, meeting Hubby.
Eric? Oh, because he's swiffering around me? He's swiffering? Yeah.
Suki's husband's doing all the chores right now.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, he makes it look good, like he's cleaning up.
Suki, you tell me you do what you're cooking. You're at the supermarket. You're vacuuming.
You're
helping the kids. And,
yes.
and all I see is Eric doing chore after chore. The guy's making dinner. He's cleaning up. I mean, you let the guy give him a break for a minute. Look at him. What's happening?
It's such a lie.
He's giving the kids a bath. This is ridiculous. Give the guy a break.
All right. I can't. It's such a...
Look at him. Let him go watch TV, for God's sakes. He's working
so
all day, hooking ladder, carrying hoses.
Oh, he's so full of it. Full of it. All right, let me go, Scotty, because I got to go clean up the rest of the house.
Yeah, where are you? What do you got to do?
That's such a lie. Talk to you later.
All right, babe, I'll see you tomorrow night.
All right. Thanks, everybody, for watching. Like our page.
Night, everybody.
Spread the word, Suki and Scott Show. Good night.
Yeah, maybe tomorrow night we'll actually be on our page tomorrow night.
Yeah, you know what? We got to figure out why I couldn't link it up to mine. Weird.
Don't know.
All right.
It's all BS. Love you, babe.
See you later. Bye. Funny.